Are you suspecting something high grade?
Yes.
Okay.
Definitely.
Yeah. Wow. It's like high grade glioma. You concur on that, Jonathan?
Yeah, I don't disagree.
It could be a small cell GBM. Or,
yeah.
I think it's very hard to describe the enjoyment that we get in pathology from recognizing the patterns of both normal and diseased tissues. One of the simple ways to describe it is that we diagnose diseases of the nervous system based on tissue that is given to us, generally speaking, by neurosurgeons. And so that would include brain tumors, muscle and nerve biopsies. We deal with interesting infections, toxic and metabolic conditions, a lot of genetic conditions, autopsy tissues, which is predominantly the brain, the spinal cord, and its coverings, looking for any question of neurologic disease.
The cerebellum is wrapping around the brainstem.
And it might even be a tad hemorrhagic. I would call this early tonsillar herniation.
Okay.
Definitely would. This is the kind of case where I wouldn't be surprised if you find durae hemorrhages in the pons. There are certainly many types of examples of where we solve a puzzle. I recall a recent case of an elderly gentleman where he was concerned that he was being robbed and that he would be injured or killed. But at autopsy, he turned out to have Lewy body disease, which is something which predisposes to these sort of paranoid ideas. I was finishing a speaking engagement in Europe, and I got a call in the middle of the night from the coroner at Las Vegas asking if I would be willing to examine the brain. The shooter in the Las Vegas tragedy, the brain was then actually hand-delivered to me by the coroner. There was concern that he might have a neurodegenerative disease with the loss of inhibition. Found no evidence of any neurodegenerative disease. What my final diagnosis was in the case was that he had atherosclerosis, typical for a 64-year-old man. Nobody really expected to find a reason for his actions. However, the dimension of the tragedy dictated to some people that no stone be unturned in trying to find out if there was some form of pathology that was visible in his brain. The spectrum of disease in the nervous system is basically mirrored in my practice. There is a higher percentage of really interesting and novel pathology than there is in some other subspecialties of pathology, and it's something that gives me excitement each and every day I come to work.